Hello and welcome to the Nature for All interview series with George Greene. This interview was made possible by the Nature for All Discovery Zone. My name is Caitlin Brant and I'm from the Canadian Wildlife Federation and an alumni of the Canadian Conservation Corps. I'm joined today with Marie-Philippe Ouellet from Parks Canada and George Greene, the former Assistant Director General of the IUCN, and then the IUCN Council Member for North America and the Caribbean between 2008 and 2016. He was also the Chair of the Canadian IUCN Committee from 2012 to 2016. Thank you guys for being here. Today, we're going to be discussing three topics surrounding the IUCN, or the International Union for the Conservation of Nature, which is the largest nature conservation organization in the world, with over 17,000 plus members from over 160 countries worldwide. Our third part of the series, third and final part, is youth and IUCN. So we're going to talk about how youth can make an impact at Congress and beyond.
Youth conservation leadership and meaningful youth engagement is a key component for the World Conservation Congress and to IUCN as an organization. The first step to making an impact with the IUCN is to become a member of a relevant IUCN commission, either as part of your employer organization or as an individual.
The IUCN is implementing a multi-pronged strategy for youth engagement to ensure the wisdom, vision, demand, and energy of youth can drive the conservation movement through the IUCN Congress and beyond.
So to speak a little bit about the Global Youth Summit, in light of COVID-19 pandemic, the Global Youth Summit will offer a virtual meeting followed by a potential in-person meeting in Marseille in France when new date for the IUCN World Conservation Congress will be determined. Youth and young professional up to age of 35 years old will be able to sign up for a relevant track at the virtual summit and work with other emerging conservation leaders on capacity building as well as real world issues. So outcomes of this summit is one to draft or to create a Global Youth Summit declaration, and also to create a space for youth to share their input and influence the IUCN program. So speaking of the Congress, George, how the youth can be involved for the Congress?
I think youth are having increasing influence on conservation. I would like to see youth to actually have power in decision-making through leadership and conservation. So that's kind of an evolution, and I think we're actually at a point where there can now start to happen. There's lots of places to participate, but my thinking is that it's not just participating in the plenaries and in the forum. By the way, the forum is a great place to learn and to network, but in the end, if you want to have influence, it's going to be the members assembly. So my thought is you want to get directly involved in the decision-making body, in the Congress committees if you can, certainly by trying to take the mic in plenary. I don't mean stealing it, but I'm saying if you're a member of a delegation, a not-for-profit delegation, NGO, or a government delegation, ask your delegation to give you a chance to have your voice on matters that are of interest to you. The contact groups, which I talked in the second interview about, are really important. It's a place where you can actually, it's not closed, so any member can come and have a voice, whether you're the head of delegation or not. It's a place to put forward your views, try and convince other ones, other people. And most importantly, networking. There's so much that goes on. And some of you are already very skilled at using the corridors, if you will, to convince governments, to talk with other NGOs and NGO leaders, to try and get your view across and to actually have as much influence as a possibility. I also want to talk about the Youth Summit, which you spoke about. Yes, the Youth Summit declaration is going to be important, but in the end, what you really want to do is to get that declaration and its content recognized in the IUCN program. So the IUCN program committee and the debate on the floor on the program and the informal negotiations that go on is really where I think that's most important for youth goals, for youth initiatives to be written right into the IUCN program so that the words that have been carried here, the initiatives that you've been pushing for, become part of what IUCN is going to do in the next 4 years.
Great, thank you. Is there any other way that youth can make a difference at Congress or beyond in the IUCN?
The resolutions process is a great place to do that. And I spoke about the contact groups and how they are really a place to have lots of influence. But I also go back to networking. I've been very impressed with the youth conservation leaders that I've worked with before and how effective they are at networking and getting their positions to be taken up.
So the next question will be, what are the behind the scene based on what we just discussed?
I had the fortune, I think, to lead for the IUCN the 1996 World Conservation Congress in Montreal, working with Parks Canada, that was the host. And I was just astounded at how much work went on. So the first thing I would say is to actually recognize the work that the staff do, the secretariats. But in the Congress itself, it's the stuff that happens on the side negotiations. I will give an anecdote. Nature for All, which we are now working under, was put forward as a new initiative within IUCN. When we got to the Congress, it was not part of the draft program. We knew about it. We had a pavilion. We had lots of conversation. It's not going to be core to IUCN's work. I did a lot of horse trading with delegations and most importantly with the secretariat. I mean, one comment I would make is that secretariat people hold a lot of cards. Even though the decisions are made by the members in the General Assembly, the Members' Assembly, the secretariat holds on pretty dearly to what they already know and want. And so I had to negotiate pretty hard with some very senior members of the secretariat and trade things that they wanted in order to actually get them to agree. And then Mike Wong, who was a head negotiator for Parks Canada, the Canadian government state agency, actually insisted, raised it on the floor, put it forward, and he and I had done the legwork that in fact the secretariat would not speak against it, and the members voted in to have Nature for All. So that kind of behind the scenes work is really, really critical to advancing your goals. And I spoke earlier about things coming out of the Youth Summit to get what the things that are important to you as youth delegates into the program.
Thanks, George. I think on that, what I will invite everybody to do is to visit the Global Youth Summit website, as well as to follow Nature for All social media to make sure that you're aware of what will be the next step and how you can get involved with all the youth component of IUCN. And I think my last question to you, George, will be, if you were a youth again, what will be your recommendation or your call to action?
The very beginning of this series, I spoke about IUCN as a cause. So what is driving you? What do you really want to fight for? And then get yourself in a position to have that voice on your delegation, in the committees, on the floor, through the contact groups, but also because you have this wonderful process of preparing the youth summit. Get it into the initiatives and into the decisions that are being put forward by youth. So have your voice recognized and the things that you hold most dear and want to have influence on in what comes into the summit and ultimately into the IUCN program.
That's great advice. I think I need to do that.
For sure. Thank you for your time, George. Really appreciate and inspiring to talk with you. I think it's a wrap up.